Hi guys, welcome again to the new basic learning, and today the chapter is in continuation about the part 2. This is 5 kingdom classification for class 9. So I'm going to start in the continuation which I left in the first part. If you have not seen the first part, please check it first because this is in the continuation. If you are seeing this video randomly, so you are not going to understand anything. So please see the part 1. I have given the link in the description box. You can go and check that. So now let's start about the 5 kingdom classification part 2. In this part, we are going to learn about first how to name an organism, why we need to name an organism, and what is the use of name an organism. So by naming an organism, first of all, we will learn about common names and scientific names. Common names, suppose I am taking one fruit name. Suppose pumpkin, you all know what is pumpkin. So I will take three common names about pumpkin, that means Sitafal or Kaddu or Kashifal. But we call pumpkin. Scientific name is pumpkin. Pumpkin is a scientific name. And common names are Sitafal, Kaddu. Somewhere it is called Sitafal, somewhere it is called Kaddu, and somewhere it is called Kashifal. But a real name, or you can say scientific name, is pumpkin. So if we are talking, suppose one scientist is here. So we are talking about common names about pumpkin. So he will not understand that what we are talking about or what name we are calling out pumpkin. So he know only pumpkin. Name, scientific name only he knows. He does not know that what are the names about the pumpkin we are calling with common names. He don't know common names. He only know scientific names. Okay. Suppose your friends call you with another name. Your parents call with you another name. So that does not matter anywhere. You are called with. Okay. That means your name is Rahul. Okay, your parents called with you another name in your house, or you are called by your friends with another name. So that does not matter. जब आप कहीं बाहर जाओगे तो आपको अपने real name से ही पहचान होगी, क्योंकि passports में जो name होते हैं, passports में वही name होते हैं जो आपका real name है. That does not matter कि आपका घर में क्या नाम है, आप बाहर क्या लोग आपको बुला रहे हैं. That does not matter. So, by your scientific name, you are only called outside the world. It does not matter how your parents call you in your house or how your friends call you in your schools. So, scientific name is very important. And how to keep in order. That means, what is the order? What is the order? First, we will write about the genus and then in the species. Suppose, what is the genus of humans? Or you can say man. What is the genus of man? Homo. And species? Sapiens. Okay, now one example I will give you about the mango. What is the genus of mango? Mangifera. And what is the species of mango? Indica. Okay, so the full name, that means the scientific name, is Mangifera indica, about the mango. Scientific name of mango is Mangifera indica. So if you are talking, suppose you are talking about mango and one scientist is here. So he does not know what you are talking. Mango, he don't know mango. What is mango? He don't know. He know only Mangifera indica. The name of mango, he know that Mangifera indica. If you are talking mango, so he will not understand that what you are talking or which name you are calling out. He will only understand Mangifera indica because he knows only scientific names. Okay. So I have given the example. So now we will talk about how to write a scientific name properly. That means first genus will come and then the species will come. Genus is always written with capital letter and species is always written with small letter. Okay, suppose man, I am writing scientific name of man is Homo sapiens. So homo is written, H is written in capital, and sapiens, that means species name, is written in small letter. Okay, and about the mango, M is written in capital, and species name, that means indica, is written in small letter I. First letter of every this genus and species. Genus is always written with first capital letter, and species first letter is small letter. So this is the order how to write a scientific name. Okay, so this we have done, how to name an organism. Now we will talk about the grouping an organism. Previously I have told you how to name an organism, what is the use of naming an organism, and why we need to name an organism. So I have given one example about that. That means how to write a scientific name. That means first genus will come and then species. So why we do that? To explain or to write a scientific name. So genus and species, this is the order of naming the scientific name, to write a scientific name. Okay, so this is called a binomial clature. Binomial clature, and this was introduced by Linnaeus. Okay, this was introduced by Linnaeus, binomial clature. That means genus and species, first genus will come and then the species name will come, then only the scientific name is written properly. That is the order that nobody can change. So that's why this is called the Linnaeus introduced the binomial clature. And this, what is binomial clature? To write a scientific name in a proper order. That means genus, first genus will come and then the species name will come. Okay, so this was the binomial clature about. Now we will move to other things. So now about the grouping. Grouping, in the grouping part, 9 types of phylum comes. Under the category of grouping, 9 types of phylum comes. That means phylum Porifera, phylum Cnidaria, phylum Platyhelminthes, phylum Nematoda, phylum Annelida, phylum Arthropoda, phylum Mollusca, phylum Echinodermata, and phylum Chordata. So 9 types of phylum are there. You have to learn all these names. I can understand that this is difficult, but these are not that much difficult you to learn. Okay, so you can learn all these names. It is important in the exams. It comes named 9 types of phylums, and all the names you have to learn by, in order you have to learn. It does not matter that how you are writing. It only matters that you have to number every name serial wise. That means in a order. Porifera comes first, then second Cnidaria, third Platyhelminthes, fourth Nematoda, fifth Annelida, sixth Arthropoda, seventh Mollusca, eighth Echinodermata, and ninth Chordata. So you have to learn all these names. These are important. Now I have to tell you that first 8 are invertebrates. First 8 are invertebrates. Invertebrate means which do not have a backbone, or you can say spine, or you can say reed ki haddi. Okay, they do not have invertebrates. बहुत पहले भी आप पढ़ चुके हैं विदाउट बैकबोन. और यू कैन से स्पाइन. ओके, लास्ट वन इज वर्टिब्रेट. लास्ट वन इज वर्टिब्रेट विच हैव बैकबोन. We humans also come in the category under the category of chordata. We humans are also included in this. Okay, all mammals and all humans come under the category of chordata, which have backbone. Okay, so first 8 are invertebrates which do not have backbone, or you can say spine, or you can say reed ki haddi. Okay, and last one is chordata, which are vertebrates. That means we humans and mammals, including us also, we are vertebrates with backbone. which have backbone. So now we will understand the major differences between the vertebrates and invertebrates first. So now we will understand the major differences in between the vertebrates and invertebrates. Vertebrates which have backbone and invertebrates which do not have backbone. So vertebrates, let's see the first difference. They have internal skeleton. Internal skeleton, you can say backbone and their skeleton. One thing also I forgot to tell you that they do not have skeleton. Invertebrates, skeleton nahi hota unka. Okay, and we have skeleton. No internal skeleton is there. Then second, a backbone is present, that we know. And invertebrates, backbone is not present. Okay, then third, a tail is usually present. In vertebrates, a tail is usually present. And here in vertebrates, tail is absent. There is no tail. Then in tail example, you can say that monkey have a tail. Okay. Then fourth, heart is not, heart is on the ventral side of the body. Okay. We have the heart on the ventral side of the body and they have on the dorsal side of the body. Okay. Then they have two pairs of limbs. Okay, we know that we have two pairs of limbs, and invertebrates, they have three or more than three pairs. Okay, say they have three or more pairs of limbs if present. Okay, then sixth, hemoglobin is present in the body. Hemoglobin is present in the blood cells. We humans, in our body, in our body, the hemoglobin is present inside the blood cells. And in them, if hemoglobin is present, then it is dissolved in the blood. Okay, it is dissolved in the blood. Okay, and inside the blood cells, hemoglobin is present in our part, that means vertebrates, and in invertebrates, dissolved. It is dissolved in the blood. Okay, so this was the difference about the vertebrates and invertebrates. Now, one also major difference about the invertebrates and vertebrates is that when an embryo is formed inside the body, so it has notochord. It does not have backbone. It has notochord. Okay. When an embryo is forming inside the body, then it has notochord. It does not have backbone. Okay, when it comes out after birth, so that turns into backbone. Okay, so this was about the vertebrates and invertebrates. Now let's see the other things. So moving forward, first of all, we will understand about the phylum Porifera. It is the first phylum. Okay, so in this, you can see that Porifera is like this. Pores allow water and food material to enter inside. It means that you can see that this Porifera. Now this is like you can see pores on these. Okay, so that are pores. Okay, so they allow water to enter inside. Now the water inside the water, food material is also present in the water. So it allow to enter inside the Porifera. Okay. Then if the water goes inside, when water goes inside the Porifera, then it becomes fluffy. It becomes fluffy. Phool jata hai. Then extra water gets out, which is extra inside the Porifera. It gets out easily. Okay. Sorry. This was about the Porifera. Now Cnidaria, second one. It has two layered body. It is made up of two layered body. Okay. You can see this. This is Hydra. Example I am giving you about this Cnidaria. It is Hydra. Okay. So it has two layered body. No anus. Anus means ending part. No, you can say that we eat food and we take out it by our anus. Anus is ending part. Okay. Waste material jahan se hum bahar nikalte hain, wo usme present nahi hota. It is not present. Okay, ending part is not there in the Hydra. So, from where it eats the food, from that only it take out. Then eats through tentacles. These are the tentacles. These. यू कैन सी लेग्स, जो ये लेग्स की तरह आपको दिख रहे हैं ये टेंटिकल्स होते हैं, इनकी एंडिंग पार्ट जो होती है ना, एंडिंग पार्ट ये होते हैं टेंटिकल्स. ओके सो दे ईट फ्रॉम टेंटिकल्स एंड दीज आर कार्निवोरस. कार्निवोरस यू कैन से दैट दे ईट इंसेक्ट टाइप्स ऑर्गेनिजम्स, दे डू नॉट ईट प्लांट और एनी, दे आर नॉट हर्बीवोरस, दे आर कार्निवोरस, दे ईट इंसेक्ट टाइप्स ऑर्गेनिजम्स एंड दे आर पैरासाइट टाइप. पैरासाइट मीन्स दे आर अटैच टू अनदर प्लांट. ओके then mostly they are found in oceans, mostly they are found in oceans or on watery area. So this was about the Cnidaria and Porifera, two we have done. Now let's move to the other phylums. Now the third is Platyhelminthes. Platyhelminthes is the third phylum, phylum Platyhelminthes. Now it has flatworms, means flatworms comes under the category of Platyhelminthes. Okay, you can see this one. Then these are also parasite type, they are stick on other animals. Okay, chipak jaate hain dusre animals par and they suck blood from them. They suck blood. Okay, then fourth is nematoda. Example for nematoda is hookworms. Hookworms, you can see this one. And it has mouth also and anus also. That means eating part also and digestive part also. Okay. So it has mouth also and anus also. Now let's see the fifth one. So now we will start about the fifth one, which is Annelida. Earthworms comes under the Annelida category. You can see this one. This is earthworm and mostly they live in wet soil. Okay, wet soil. Wet means geely mitti. Then nocturnal. Nocturnal means that they are active in night. Okay, they avoid sunlight. Then use for agriculture. That means agriculture, in the agriculture, first benefit is only in the agriculture. They make manure. You can say that makes high quality of manure. How? They are waste material which they eat and take out by their body, so that material mix in the soil and it makes high quality of manure. Then it avoids sunlight, as I told you before. Then arthropoda, sixth one, jointed legs. Example, spider and crabs. Crabs, you have seen that they have joint legs, and spider also. So the main category is about the jointed legs. Then mollusca, seventh one. Example, you can say octopus. They are foot muscular. That means they which help them to move. Or you can say which help them to walk. Octopus, example. Then eighth one, echinodermata. Example, starfish. They are symmetrical type. You have seen a starfish, obviously, that it is of star shape. Sorry. Or you can make like this. So it is of symmetrical shape. Like this. Okay, so it is of symmetrical shape. In this, under the category of echinodermata, example, I have given you starfish. So they are symmetrical type. So that comes under the category of echinodermata. Now let's see the last one, chordata. So now the fifth category is about the chordata. Sorry, last one, ninth one. Okay, so last one is the chordata. Now, one thing I want to clear you that eight parts which I told you, eight phylums that were invertebrates that do not have backbone. Now we will understand about the last category, which is vertebrate. Okay, that means with backbone, they have spine. Okay, so chordata, it also consists of five categories, which is pisces, amphibia, reptiles, fourth is aves, and fifth is mammalia. So first we will understand about the pisces. Under the pisces, you can take the example of fishes. They have two chambered hearts, okay? Then they breathe through their gills and they are cold-blooded. We humans are warm-blooded. You know all that. Okay, warm-blooded means if someone takes out the blood or if our blood comes out, then it is warm. Okay, it is not cold. Now they are cold-blooded. Okay, then two types of fishes are there. That is cartilage fish and bony fish. Cartilage example you can take about the shark. And bony fish you can take about the crabs. cartilage, it means that it is the skeleton is made up of cartilage. Okay. And bony fish, that means it is made up of bones. That you can example, you can take the carbs. Then second one is amphibia. Example, frog. Amphibian means which lives on land as well as on water. Okay, so they live on land also and water also. They have three chambered hearts. Okay, and blood is cold. They are cold-blooded. Then third is about the reptiles. Example, you all know that reptiles you have learned before also. Example, you can take lizards and snakes and many other. So they have also three chambered hearts. They are cold-blooded and they breathe through lungs. Okay. अभी तक हम क्या पढ़ रहे थे? They breathe by gills. Now this is about the lungs. So reptiles breathe through lungs. Okay. So now we have done. Now let's move to the fourth one. So now the fourth is about the apes. Apes means birds only. Birds comes under the category of apes. Now they have four chambered heart, warm-blooded. They are warm-blooded. Okay, you have to keep in mind that they are warm-blooded. Then give eggs. Okay. Then mammalia. Under the category, we also come in under the category of mammalia. Okay, so humans also come under this. Gives birth to young one. Okay, they give birth to young ones. Then mammary glands, from where they suck blood. Sorry, from where they suck milk. Then breathe through lungs. Breathe through lungs. Okay, you all know this, we breathe through lungs. Then hair on skin. Hair is present on the skin. Then they have ears also. And you can say other things. Then now you will tell me in the comment section that we how much chambers we have. Okay, I will not tell you here. You will tell me that how many chambers we have, we humans have. Okay, so please comment me in the comment section that how many chambers do human have. Okay, so this was all about this chapter, five kingdom classification, part one also I have made, part two also I have done. So, if you have not seen the both parts, you can see, I have given the link in the description box about the part 1. So, if you like this video, please hit the like button, share my video, subscribe our channel and hit the bell icon to get the more latest updates. Thank you for watching.